desire, but you're always look for, you're always desire.
Thank you. temptation, Lord, is in you.
What a wonder, what a wonder, what a wonder, what a wonder.
made a way where there was no way. You brought a home where there was no hope. You made a way where there was no way. You brought a home where there was no hope. Yes, you made a way where there was no way. You brought a home where there was no hope. Wonderful grace.
What a wonder, what a wonder, what a wonder, what a wonderful way. What a wonder, what a wonder, what a wonder, what a wonderful grace. What a wonder, what a wonder, what a wonder, what a wonderful way that you have made, that you have made, Lord, that you have made, that you have made.
We adore. We adore. worship you, Lord. We worship, we worship, we worship you with the sound of joy, with the sound of praise, with the sound of thanksgiving. Give thanks, oh, we give thanks to you. sing of you, Lord. Forever will I sing, forever will I sing of my Redeemer's love. My Redeemer's love. Forever will I sing, forever will I sing of my Redeemer's love. Of my Redeemer's love. Forever will I sing, forever will I sing my Redeemer's love. My Redeemer's love. My Redeemer's love. Redeemer's love. Oh, forever will I sing, forever will I sing, forever will I sing of my Redeemer's love, of your love, Lord. Oh, forever will I sing, forever will I sing, forever will I sing of my Redeemer's King of glory, we adore you. Oh, King of glory, we adore you. King of glory, we adore you. King of glory, we adore you, King of glory. 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 We adore you. King of glory, 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 we adore you. King of glory. King of glory, we adore you. King of glory, we adore you. King of glory, we adore you. Come on, say. True Lord, yes, you alone are.
worship you. We worship you, Lord. In the Spirit, in the Spirit, by the Spirit, by the Holy Spirit. Yes, you are ever faithful, and you are ever true. So we rejoice in you.
rejoice in you. Lord, we rejoice in you. Lord, we rejoice in you. We rejoice in you. We rejoice in you. We rejoice in you. For you fill our mouths with laughter. You fill our hearts with praise. Yes, you fill our mouths with laughter. You fill our hearts with praise. You fill our mouths with laughter. You fill our hearts with praise. You fill our mouths with laughter. You fill our hearts with praise. You fill our hearts with laughter. You fill our hearts with praise. You fill our mouths with laughter. You fill our hearts with praise. You fill our mouths with laughter. You fill our hearts with praise. Our mouths with laughter, you fill our hearts with praise. And there's nothing like your presence. 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 There's nothing like your we magnify. magnify. We glorify. Sing it now. We magnify. We glorify. We magnify. We glorify. We magnify. Your name, Lord Jesus, we glorify. We magnify. We glorify. Yes, we magnify. We glorify from the depths of our being, God, with our everything, Lord, with all that you have given, with all you've created us to be when you gave us this life to live for you. So we surrender, holding nothing back. For we were ordained by you to bring forth praise, to bring forth worship, to bring forth worship. Not a song, but worship. So we magnify, we glorify, we magnify, we glorify. We magnify. We glorify. Yes, there's a sound of praise arising. There's a sound of praise arising up. Rising up. Let those who know the joyful sound sing. Let all who know the joyful sound sing. Let all who know the joyful sound sing a new song. Sing a new song. Sing a new song. And sing a new song to the Lord. Sing a new song. Sing a new song. We worship you. We worship you. We worship you. Nothing else we'd rather do. We worship you. We worship you. We worship you. Yes, we worship you. We worship you. We worship you. Come on, that's it. Come on now. How beautiful the praises of his people. We were. We were shy. We were shy. We worship you. We worship you. Whole armies were defeated with just that right there, just the sound of praise. We worship. You're unstoppable when you have the voice of praise, the voice of worship coming forth. Oh, that praise. Oh, that offering. Oh, that offering. The offering of worship. We worship.
We
Father, Sovereign Lord, have your way in us tonight. Lord, your will and your way. Your way, Lord. We look to you, Lord. We look to you, Lord. We want nothing else but you. We want nothing else but you. We want nothing else but you. Nothing but the fire and the rain and the wind of the Spirit. Oh, the fire and the wind and the rain of the Spirit. The movings of your Spirit. Lord, let the movings of faith, let the hearings of faith be here tonight, Lord. Lord, that every heart be stirred, that every eye be open to see. Lord, that there be no hindrance, nothing standing in the way, Lord, but rather a free course. A free course, have free course in our life, Lord. Hallelujah. 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 Lord, we honor you. We reverence you. You're welcome, be welcome in this place. Lord, your presence. Lord, your presence. Lord, your anointing. Lord, we want nothing of man. Lord, we want nothing of any human ability, God, but only that which is from, breathed by your Spirit. Oh, for the Spirit and the Bride say, come. The Spirit and the Bride say, come. Oh, the Spirit and the Bride say, come. Oh, the Spirit and the Bride say, come. And all who hear say, come. And all who hear say, come. Yes, all who hear say, come. And drink of these waters. And drink of these waters. Drink of these waters. Lord, we drink from these waters. We drink of these waters. And it shall be in you a wellspring springing up. Yes, it will be in you a wellspring springing up. Oh, the Spirit says, come. Oh, the Spirit says, come. And the Bride says, come. Oh, the Spirit says, come. Oh, the Bride says, come. Come to the table. He's prepared for you. Come to the table. He's made a special spot for you. Oh, come to the table. Oh, there's a feast prepared.
Oh, come to the table. Oh, come to the table. Come and die. Come and die. And the Spirit says, come. And the bride says, come. And all who hear say, come. Oh, all who hear say, come. And drink of these waters. Lord, we drink of these waters. Oh, the depths, oh, the riches of his love, past finding out, unsearchable his greatness, unsearchable his greatness. Infinite, infinite. Infinite his greatness. Infinite his greatness. And he's called us into his greatness. He's called us into his greatness. Oh, for he called us out of darkness. Oh, he called us out of darkness. Oh, and he brought us into this marvelous light. Into the light, to the light and the life of God, to the light and the light of Christ, the life of Christ. Great is the Lord and greatly to be praised. Great is the Lord and greatly to be praised. Great is the Lord and greatly to be praised. Great is the Lord and greatly to be praised. Great is the Lord and greatly to be praised. Great is the Lord and greatly to be praised. Great is the Lord and greatly to be praised. Great is the Lord and greatly to be praised. Greatly to be praised. Oh, great is the Lord and greatly to be praised. Great is the Lord and greatly to be praised. Oh, great is the Lord and greatly to be praised. Great is the Lord and greatly to be praised. And your works, they praise you. Oh, all your works, they praise you. Lord, all your works, they praise you. All your works, they praise you. And we praise you. 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 The Lord and greatly to be praised. Great is the Lord and greatly to be praised. Praised. Oh, great is the Lord and greatly to be praised. Great is the Lord and greatly to be praised. Praised. Oh, great is the Lord and greatly to be praised. Great is the Lord and greatly to be praised. your word, all your works say praise you, and all your word, all your works, they praise you, and we praise you, oh, we praise you, we praise you, Father, we praise you, Lord, we praise you, Lord, we praise you, Lord, we praise you, Lord, oh, for great is the Lord, and greatly to be praised, great is the Lord, and greatly to be praised. Oh, great is the Lord, and greatly to be praised. Great is the Lord, and greatly to be praised. Praised. Oh, great is the Lord, and greatly to be praised. Great is the Lord, and greatly to be praised. A beautiful for situation. We're in beautiful situations. Because the Lord is on our side, the Lord, he takes our part. Oh, for we acknowledge him, and he directs our path. He leads us in the way we ought to go. Oh, we acknowledge him, and he directs our path. And he leads us in the way we ought to go. Oh, we acknowledge him, and he directs our path. And leads us in the way to go. Oh, the amazing God, but we acknowledge you, and you direct our paths, and you lead us in the way to go. But we acknowledge you, and you direct our paths, and lead us in the way to go. But we acknowledge you, and you direct our paths, and lead us in the way to go. But we acknowledge you. Oh. Well, we acknowledge you, you direct our path, and lead us in the way to go. Yes, we acknowledge you, and you direct our path, and lead us in the way to go. And we follow, we follow, we follow, we follow. We follow, we follow you, we follow, we follow, we follow, we follow you, we follow, we will follow, we will follow, we will follow you, we will follow, we will follow, we will follow, Lord, we will follow, we will follow, we will follow, we will follow you. We will follow, we will follow, we will follow. Wherever you lead us, wherever you lead us, wherever you lead us. We will follow, we will follow, we will follow, we will follow you, we will follow, we will follow. We will follow, we will follow you, we will follow, we will follow, we will follow, we will follow you, we will follow, we will follow, we will follow, we will follow you, Lord. For you are the good shepherd. You are the good shepherd. Oh. And we will follow, we will follow, we will follow, we will follow you, we will follow, we will follow, we will follow, we will follow you, we will follow, we will follow, we will follow, we will follow you. For you lead us, you lead us into paths of righteousness. You lead us beside still waters. You restore our soul. And surely Surely goodness and mercy. Surely goodness and mercy surround us as we follow you. And we will dwell with you, Lord. In the house, in your house, Lord. We will dwell with you. In your house, oh Lord. We will dwell with you. In your house, oh Lord, forever and ever. We will dwell with you in your house, oh Lord. We will dwell with you in your house, oh Lord. We will dwell with you in your house, oh Lord. We will dwell with you in your house, oh Lord. For you prepared a place for us, that where you are we may be also. And in your house are many dwellings. In your house are many dwellings. Oh, but keep me far from the camp of the wicked. Keep us far from the camp of the wicked. Keep us far from the camp of the wicked. Oh, oh, for I'd rather be a doorkeeper. I'd rather be a doorkeeper. I'd rather be a doorkeeper in the house of my God, in the house of my God, than to dwell in the tents of the wicked. No, to dwell in the tents of the wicked. No, to dwell in the tents of the wicked. No, not dwelling there, but my dwelling is in you, Lord. Our dwelling is in you. Sing it, saints. Our dwelling is in you. Our dwelling is in you. Our dwelling is in you, Lord. Our dwelling is in you. 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 Our dwelling is in you, Lord. Gotta sing it. My dwelling is in you. My dwelling is in you. My dwelling is in you, Lord. Our dwelling is in you. Our dwelling is in you. Our dwelling is in you, Lord. Our dwelling is in you. Our dwelling is in you. Our dwelling is in you, Lord. Throughout the ages. Throughout the ages. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Welcome tonight. There's nothing so precious to me than hearing God's people enter into a realm of worship. And I know that's the case because that's what the Father loves. That's what he's seeking for, those who worship him in spirit and truth. And, you know, it's easy sometimes to get caught up in songs and words, but it's so much simpler than that. With just the simple words, I worship you, Lord. I worship you, Lord. Nations can be changed. Nations can be changed. Whole armies that stood in the way of God's people were just demolished through the praises, through God inhabiting the praises of his people. You get to praise him, and the Lord hears it. He hears it. And he already loves us so much, and his eyes are already on us. But even that much more so, I could just see him, you know, just that much more intensely gazed at us, just inhabiting our praises. May we live a life of praise. May we live a life of prayer. But more importantly, and what springs from it all, may we live a life of consecration. Many in the church have forgotten the consecration, the call to consecration, the call to consecration. And let those who think they stand examine themselves. Let those who think they stand examine themselves. For everyone's works will be tried by fire. Everyone's works will be tried by fire. Lord, we dedicate ourselves, Lord, to sowing into the realms of the Spirit that we might reap, Lord, the realms of the Spirit, that everlasting life, the life of the Spirit. Lord, may each one of us examine ourselves, Lord, and have proper order, the order of the kingdom in our lives, God. Lord, for surely, you deserve the best of all we can give. You deserve the best, Lord. Lord, so we devote ourselves to giving you the best. To giving you the best of our life. To giving you the best of our abilities. To giving you the best of our time, Lord. To giving you the best of our being. Hallelujah. Well, welcome tonight. I'm excited about what God's doing. It's exciting times to be living in many ways. For the Lord is faithful, and he is ever true. And he's jealous over his people. And he's jealous over the name of his son, Jesus. And he will have his way. He will have his way. For he alone is sovereign and supreme. He alone is the eternal wise God, creator of the heavens and the earth, and all that dwell therein. And how amazing he's called us his chosen people. He's called us elected and chosen. He's elected us and chosen us to bring forth praise. He calls us the chosen generation. Those who he's given white robes to, purchased by the blood of Jesus. He's given us beautiful garments of praise. When all we had was filthy rags, he gave us beautiful garments. Well, I love his presence, and you know, that's really all we're about, is living to show forth his glory and having his presence revealed in our lives. I love the stirrings of God, and I'm dissatisfied with anything else. All the Lord needs is a little bit of hunger, and he just fills us. He just fills us. He says, blessed are they who hunger and thirst after righteousness, for they will be filled. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they shall be called the sons of God. I love the peace of his presence. There's nothing like his glory and there's nothing like his presence. Hallelujah. I just want to quote Psalms 1 real quick before my lovely wife comes and helps minister here. Psalms 1 verse 1 says, "Blessed is the man who walks not in the counsel of the ungodly, nor stands in the way of sinners, nor sits in the seat of the scornful. But his delight is in the law of the Lord, and in his law does he meditate day and night. And he shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of water that bring forth fruit in his season. His leaf shall not wither, and whatever he does shall prosper. The ungodly are not so, but are like the chaff which the wind drives away." Therefore, the ungodly shall not stand in the judgment, nor sinners in the congregation of the righteous. For the Lord knows the way of the righteous, but the way of the ungodly shall perish. Lord, we delight in your law. We delight in your righteousness. Lord, our confession is that of righteousness. Lord, that you have written your law in our hearts and our minds, God. Lord, that we know your ways and we walk therein. And we stand against anything that would try to come against that in the name and by the blood of Jesus.
It's so good to be back at this church. Woo! Let's give the Lord a big shout and praise. That was a little weak, guys. Let's give him a shout and praise. Hallelujah! Thank you, Jesus! I know you guys were doing workplace evangelism and schoolplace evangelism all day, but we can rebuke the tiredness of body, be filled to overflow. Especially all the tired mommies. There's a lot of babies coming. There's a lot of babies that just came. But we can be filled up to overflow. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, man. The Lord is good. He is so good. He is so faithful. He is so faithful, and he is so worthy. And I love Wednesday. I always talk about this, but I love midweek service. You know why? It's an extra IV that we need to just get fired up in his presence to go blast out the things that he's doing to everyone in our workplace and everyone in our schools, everyone on the streets, at In-N-Out. I don't care where you go from here to next Sunday. You are going to touch people and see miracles, signs, and wonders happen. Amen? Amen. So you're going to get filled up tonight. You don't just come here to take up a spot, or your mom or dad told you you had to come, or your accountability partner is going to call you later and say, where are you at? Where have you been? Right? You come. come here because you are hungry and thirsty after the things of God, and you want to be filled up. We all want to be filled up. You guys, this is such a glorious church. And when I moved to San Diego a decade ago, I went to 26 churches when I came here. 26, no joke. I was getting a little weary about finding a church that was really doing the things that God spoke about. I was raised in a Catholic church, and I didn't know a whole lot about this Bible. But the second I read it, I was like, all right, let's do these things. Where are these things? Why aren't we doing these things? And when I came to the Abiding Place, I sat in the back at our old building, and the hair on my neck stood up. I felt this tangible presence of the Lord as that gorgeous worship pastor started singing. And I was just began to weep. And I was just overcome by the presence of the Lord. And I knew he was glorified in this church. And I knew that he delighted in this people here. And I am so honored to be a part of this ministry. I'm so honored to be a part of your church family and to just be doing the things that God has commanded us to do in the full gospel, not the partial gospel, not the one book, not the one verse. Amen. Amen. You guys, oh, you encourage me so much. One of the greatest things I love about this church is exactly what I'm going to talk about tonight is when Pastor Mark stood up outside on Sunday and he said, guys, we have to get busy. We have to go and we have to get busy. And not only that day and still up to today, I got texts and messages from you guys. We got to get busy. What are you doing with Planned Parenthood? What are we doing at Turning Point? What are we doing in evangelism? What are we doing? And tonight I'm going to tell you what we're doing. We're getting activated in our faith to go out and do big things for God, because that is what he's called us to do. Not to be in these four walls, to get fired up by Pastor Mark, who's the most amazing anointed preacher in the entire planet. I promise you that. Some of you have been here since you've been in diapers, so you probably haven't seen 26 churches in your own local community, but I have, and I can testify to tell you that Pastor Mark is here to make sure we all make heaven, and praise Jesus for that. Praise God that he's not worried about what comes in the offering basket, that he cares about us making heaven, and he cares about this community and this world and them hearing the true gospel of Jesus Christ. And it's such an honor for me. I get nervous when he texts me and says, can you take the meeting? I'm like, oh, dear God. Lord, only through you. Your word says that you'll give us the words. I said, Pastor, can I bring up my notes? They'll be my word, my notes with the scriptures in them. But some of them are the notes of things that he said. How many of you guys bring a journal to church? Amen. How many times have Pastor said recently, bring a pen and paper, write some of these things down. They might help you this week, right? When I leave on Sundays, I go home and I rewrite those notes because they're usually scribbles with a Naomi spit up or something. But I go home and I rewrite those notes, and that's what fuels my spirit. The things that Pastor speaks are not things that he thinks is good or that he read in the New York Times. Those are the things divinely from the Holy Ghost that is downloaded to him for you, for me, for people on the web. I know there's a lot of you watching tonight, which is amazing. But this is for us, so we should be activated. When you go to school, I sit in the front row. They always called those the $1 million or the straight A seats. I'm like, amen, I'll receive that. This is a lot of money for tuition. I'll take a straight A and $1 million afterwards. But I love being on the front row here. I'm so proud of this youth group that is always on the front row, pressed in, not allowing the tiredness of body to take over, taking notes and being activated. Guys, this is our time. This is our time. We are seeing a social collapse happen right now in our nation. When Pastor talked about missiles coming over our head, do you not know what's going on in Korea right now about the missiles? I mean, this is the time. It's not in the middle of the disaster when the missiles are over our head and mass destruction happens. Are we going to wake up and say, oh man, that faith. Oh yeah, I got to fill up. Wow, what does that look like? And that's what we're going to talk about tonight, guys. We're going to talk about faith in action. And so I want you guys to know we have a decision to make. Every time we walk into this church, we have a decision to make. We can sit here, we can judge whoever's talking, we can say the worship went too long, we can be too hot, too smelly, we can be too hungry, too thirsty, or we can come here and rip all that stuff off when you walk through those double doors and say, God, I'm here to receive what you have for me. Fill me up, change me, from glory to glory in the presence of you. Father, I want more. I want more. I come in here, I'm like, Lord, I'm not good enough. Never. I want to leave this place different than I came in. Every single service. You know, Pastor was right when he said we have ration. We have just survival rations of church. That is so true. Praise God I married this man behind me because we have church all day. This guy does not stop playing that guitar, and I can be a witness. All of you that come to my house, that car is always playing, and he's always giving worship. But praise Jesus, I have a four-year-old and a one-year-old that are always worshiping the Lord. They're always doing church. Anna will line up all of her little babies, even Olaf, even the ones that are undressed. She goes, all right, guys, it's time for church. Puts her hands up, prays over them, starts telling them, you got to flow in the Holy Ghost. Naomi, flow in the Holy Ghost. You got to go deeper, Naomi. You got to go deeper. Praise Jesus. That's why I am so blessed my kids are being raised in this church, and I'm blessed that you are raising your kids in this church because they are going to be world changers. They have people like Pastor Ruth and Pastor Daniel over them speaking into their lives, taking calls at 3 a.m. because they are devoted to seeing you guys make heaven. Praise God for people like that. There's not a lot of people on this earth like that. I will tell you this. They could care less about what your souls are doing because it's all about pride of life and how much money we're making and where's my Lamborghini and where's my next vacation. All right, amen. Thank you, Jesus. So tonight we have a decision to make. We can come in here and we can change from glory to glory, right? Or we can sit in here and we can just get tired. We can just be hot. It's hot. It's hot. Who cares? It's hot. It's cold other places. It's snowing in Calgary. So figure, choose your battle. We can sit in here, or we can say, Father, I want to burn in the fire of fires. Your fire. I want to be changed. I want to walk out this place different than I came in. I want to go into work tomorrow, and someone says, Martha, what is on you, girl? And you're like, that's the power of the Holy Spirit. What do you need? I have the supply right here. I'm going to lay hands on you and watch you get healed. Amen. I dropped Anna off at school. I saw a girl. She had so many issues going on. She, since I was a nurse, I told her that. She told me about all these different things. Dr. Stewart probably doesn't even know him. I was like, what in the world? You have like 52,000 different diagnoses. Well, in Jesus' name, I command your whole body to be healed. And she was like, aren't you going to give me nursing advice? I'm like, no, I have no advice for you, but I have the power of the Holy Spirit that can change you right now. And that's what we're supposed to be doing, you guys. Now there's never been a bigger time. I was so impressed today on social media where there was a shooting today of news anchors. I don't know. I didn't see that. But I saw a girl who I've never seen preach the gospel on the internet at all. And she said, did they know that that was the last time they were going to brush their teeth today? Did those news anchors know this? Did they know that was the last time they say goodbye to the loved ones? Absolutely. But guys, we don't know if that's going to be us. We have no idea what happens when we leave this place. And I'll testify to this. 4.5 years ago, I was a dead woman. I was a dead woman. I knew it. I have enough medical degrees to know it. When they told me what was going on in my body, and I already knew my body had been dying for 3 straight days, and they said they weren't going to do anything for me. They were literally just going to watch me die. And my husband, Joshua Spitsbergen, grabbed my hand, and he said, you're just fine. He spoke faith into that because he was built up in faith. He didn't just get it right then. He looked at the situation of them telling me that his wife and daughter wasn't going to make it. He said, you will be fine. He declared the word of the Lord to me, and I'm standing here today to testify that miracle to you and testify of little Anna and what the Lord did. But you guys, that's what we need to activate tonight. We have to be filled up to overflow. We have to have those situations where you're sitting in a medical diagnosis and all of a sudden no one's going to do anything for you. Nothing. They weren't even going to touch my body. They said, it's over. She'll seize. She'll stroke. She'll be dead. The baby's not going to make it either. That's exactly what came out of their mouth. My husband, my witness, Pastor Mark and Pastor Ann as well. But he spoke faith. The power of God hit that room. And I'm here to share that story with you guys and encourage you that that's what the Lord is calling us to do. And I got a lot of scripture to back it up, so I better start moving. All right, there's no greater power, guys, than declaring the words of God. We're talking about faith in action. Please open with me to James 1, 22-25. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, mighty God. No better chapter to get into, guys, if you're looking for faith matched with action than the book of James. And James, here it says, James 22, be doers of the word, not hearers only. deceiving yourselves. For if anyone is a hearer of the word, but not a doer, he is like a man observing his natural face in a mirror. For he observes himself, goes away, and immediately forgets what kind of man he was. But he who looks into the perfect law of liberty and continues in it, and is not forgetful hearer, but a doer of the work, this one will be blessed in what he does. This one will be blessed in what he does. I like the Dake Study Bible, and they, because they translate the Greek when I don't have Pastor Mark right next to me, who knows the entire language. But the Greek word for to continue therein is paramino, to stay beside, stand by, stand fast. The idea is taken from women spending much time in the mirror, decorating themselves to the greatest advantage, not leaving one hair out of place or an ornament. Thus, if one was as careful to take every advantage of the word of God, to keep his soul saved and his life conformed to the gospel, he will be blessed indeed. Guys, that's amazing. That is incredible. That is incredible. To think that, I get fired up when I read the word of God. I'm the same way at home. It's not just being here. I tell you, I get really excited. I preached to a guy for 20 minutes yesterday. I was making a logo for the business. The next thing we're doing is talking about the fire of God being hooked up with ministry serving business. And he goes, okay, so back to that. Are you going to text me the logo? I'm like, yeah, but back to business serving ministry. You understand that, right? That's what we're called to do. I love the word of God, right? I love the word of God. The word of God never returns void, so it's not falling on deaf ears. But you guys can open your ears up and receive it and get a whole lot more. I'll tell you that tonight. Amen. All right, let's go to Galatians 3:5. Galatians 3:5. Is this good? Is anyone getting anything from it? Amen. All right, Micah's in it. Amen. Amen, amen. Galatians 3:5. Everyone's there because you guys are awesome. Therefore, he that supplies you the Spirit and works miracles by you, is it through the works of the law or through the hearing of faith? I love this. I got to read it again. Therefore, he that supplies the Spirit and works miracles by you, is it through the works of the law or through the hearing of faith? A better contrast between the powerful works of faith and the ineffective works of the law cannot be found in a single verse of Scripture. The supply of the Spirit that works miracles comes out of an act of obedience to faith. Faith is not sterile and lifeless set of ideas, but an active display of the power of God. Amen? Let's say that together. An active display of the power of God. You guys, when we talk about stories like Joshua and the miracles and signs and wonders that you guys have done, it is not by a law. It is by the active power of God. And I love when Ruth Anna gets in my face, and I love that. I love that. She's like, where are the fruits? Where are the fruits of their ministry? And it's so true. Where are the fruits of your ministry? If you're ministering to people, where are the fruits? Where is that power? Where is the demonstration? When you're laying hands, are they getting set free? Or do they run back to the bar and fall on their face again as an alcoholic? Or do they turn from their wicked ways and repent 180 degrees? Where are your fruits? I question you if you are mentoring people in this church. Where are the fruits of your labors? Are you in church? Are you really getting pressed into? Are you listening to the pastor? Are you being corrected and rebuking? Or are you saying, oh no, I got my own ministry going on, pastor. Don't worry about it. I'm doing my thing right here. That's a disconnect. That's the wrong spirit to have. You need to be hooked up with the right flow, the right anointing, the right leadership that you guys have had in your lives that we are so blessed to have that active display of the power of God. The works of the law, which depend on human ability, cannot produce the wonder-working power of God, but the works of faith can. Faith is proof of the divine activity of God in the believer that results in those things that only God can do. Paul gives us a choice. Do we want the works of man or the works of God in our life? How is the works of man working for you? I just want to ask. Is it working for anyone? How about working with the power from on high in our lives to do the things which he's called us to do above and beyond all we could ever ask or imagine in our own lives? Amen? Who's hooked up with that power? Who wants more of that power in their lives?
amen and amen. And that's why you're here. And when you respond to the word of God, I mean, I might look like a fool some of the times in church. I don't even care. I don't know what I look like when I dance. I don't know what I look like when I throw my hands in the air. I mean, I don't really care. I am just wanting more of whatever's coming from here into my life. I want to be activated in so many ways. When I told Pastor I was going to fund the Mission Training Center, and then he said it was $1.2 million, I'm like, amazing. Hallelujah. We're doing it. And I hung up the phone. I looked at Joshua. I'm like, okay, stayed awake the entire night. Guess why? I thought, how is Allie going to do this? I just committed to my pastor $1.2 million. But guess what? That was the voice of the enemy trying to shut me down. Because guess what? That dream, that vision, that proclamation of that, that was the Holy Spirit. It doesn't matter about me and how good I am in business. I'm not that good at business, let's be honest. I'm with my sister now, she'll tell you. But that proclamation and me hooking up with that activated faith and power in the Holy Spirit, the Lord is funding the Mission Training Center through this business because I would not stand to be in fear and not go after it. I said, Lord, you will do it. You will do it. And he is doing it. But in that power is being displayed through so many different things, through so many miracles and workplace ministry. All we have, you guys, in whatever we do is a platform to proclaim Jesus, to proclaim the words of life to our coworkers, amen, and to your students. And so I have an amazing story that I want to share about the power. So we moved to Santa Cruz. Who's been to Santa Cruz? Santa Cruz is 96% unchurched. The first weekend we were there, I was sharing with the miracle of Jesus in my daughter's life, and someone tried to tell me she was reincarnated from a tree to do, and I was just like, I didn't know how hard this place was going to be, but now I know. Thank you, Jesus. But I didn't let that stop me, because guess what, you guys? I have the faith, the active faith. You don't need my notes. I got the word. This is my active faith. I got the word of God, and I knew that we were going to see signs, wonders, and miracles. I knew when we were sent out of this church to be there for his PhD that we were going to see signs, wonders, miracles. I didn't realize how hard the ground was, but who cares? God sent us there for a reason. So I'm in my first Bible study there, and I'm a little fiery, right? I get a little excited. People are sharing their prayer requests and how they have like 15 different issues in their body and how life is just horrible and we're all sinners and we're never going to be set free and we live in a prison. And I'm like, oh, wow, Lord. Okay, it's all good. It's all good. Just, you know, wisdom. Thank you. And so this beautiful lady, she was the first people to welcome us to the church. Her whole family sat behind me. And she started sharing about how she had just gone to the doctor and that she has depression because they just moved to a different city. She's starting a new job and that she needed to get these antidepressants and all would be well. This woman was a counselor at a Christian college who was, yes, working as a Christian with these people. Then she was supposed to go home and take these drugs that was going to help her be better in her workplace and better as a mommy and better as a wife. So I love this girl. She's watching tonight, Tracy, and she's actually flying in because she wants to be in the abiding place. When we moved here, she's like, I am coming to the abiding place. And so nonetheless, we get done with the meeting, and I was like, do you believe that God can heal you from this? And she's like, yeah, and she has this prescription for the lorazepam, for the antidepressant med, and she's asking me about it. I'm like, oh, Lord. So I said, do you believe that the Lord can heal you from this? And she says, yeah. And literally, when she spoke out that faith, that she had just a mustard seed as a Nazarene that never saw a demonstration of the power of the Holy Spirit, never in her life, I sat in this parking lot after this Bible study, and I watched that stuff melt straight off her shoulders. I watched her whole demeanor from this to this joy unspeakable bubbling up over her, and she was like, what is happening to me? I'm like, that is the power of the Holy Spirit setting you free from this demonic stronghold and whatever else is trying to get onto your life. And right now, you're going to rip up that thing. You do not need those drugs, and you are going to live days of heaven on earth. And guys, she is living days of heaven on earth. She'll be here to testify about it, which is amazing. And so it gets better. So we pray in tongues, right? We believe in the tongues. Our church up there didn't believe in tongues, which is fine because I pray in tongues, my husband prays in tongues, we sing in tongues, we do everything in tongues. So Tracy, a Nazarene, said, I've prayed for that, but I've never got it, so maybe God doesn't want me to have it. I'm like, oh, this is good. He doesn't want you to have it. Do you know that my church, with all these beautiful people, was birthed out of a Nazarene university? Oh, she went to Point Loma. She went to Point Loma, too. And she said, really? I said, yeah. And they all flow in the Holy Spirit like that. And she said, okay. So she prays. She doesn't get it. She prays. She doesn't get it. Now she's starting to get discouraged. So we're driving on this crazy road, the 17. I literally almost went into Forest a couple times. And I said, why don't we wait till we get home and we'll continue to pray because I'm not doing so good on the road. So we get home. My gorgeous husband's sitting in the chair. It was church. It was a Wednesday night. Pastor Mark's on. We're getting ready for church. I said, Joshua, you know, I just start laying hands on her because I was going to see her baptized with the Holy Ghost. I was moving to San Diego, and I was going to see this happen and see this girl just go radical in Santa Cruz because we're out of there. And so we start praying for her. Nothing happens. How many times has that happened for you guys? Over and over and over again. Do you stop? Amen. Amen. So I'm like, I'm going to keep praying. So you can see a little bit of discouragement setting in. And I was like, girl, you got this. You're going to pray in the Holy Spirit from here all the way to Watsonville, 40 minutes away. She backs out of our driveway. She gets hit by the Holy Ghost and fire. She starts praying in the Holy Spirit. She's literally translated from our driveway to her driveway, does not know how she got there, but knows that she's filled with the Holy Spirit, set on fire for God, and she's in a Christian school, Monta Vista Christian, and people are just like, what are you doing? And she's like, you need this, and watch The Abiding Place, and find it on YouTube, because you all need this in your life. And so those are the types of things, you guys, that fire me up. Those are the type of people, like, I loved what you know, Pastor had to say to you, Brittany, summer was ripe for the picking. She was so ripe for the picking. And you know how you saved her? She told me, your love for the people at Burger Lounge. It wasn't that you preached the gospel and you knew every single scripture backward and forward. It was how you loved your coworkers. You never spoke an ill word. And that brought Summer into the kingdom of God. Well, at least got her to the meeting and Jesus brought her into the kingdom of God. But that is a powerful word. That is powerful that you showed them by love. By love. Look at all of our coworkers. They're watching us. They're watching if we speak bad about their boss. Watch our students. They're watching if you talk bad about the student and their girl that had purple hair. I don't even know what kids look like these days. I went to Catholic schools. We couldn't even dye hair, nail polish, nothing. But anyway, they're watching you guys. They're watching how you respond, and they know if that you are full of love, that divine love that Jesus has given us to pour out. I loved Pastor Geneva's meeting last Wednesday, or the Wednesday before, I don't know, but about that love, you guys, that is so impactful. That is so impactful. It's the demonstration of the Spirit and power that the message of the cross is proven to be far more than a religious idea created by man. The faith given to every man to inspire him to move in obedience always, say that again with me, always results in something that only God can do, that only he can do. So I don't care if you're laying hands on limbs and they're not growing out. Guess what? It will happen. It will happen. I laved a lot of hands on kids at the pediatric ICU at Rady Children's Hospital in my entire career there that did not raise from the dead. But guess what? I will see it happen. I will see a child be raised from the dead in Jesus' mighty name. I will be used in that capacity. And I don't care how many times I got laughed at and how many times people told me I gave them false expectations that I got called into the social work's office, then into my own boss's office and got rebuked and all that other crazy stuff, but we're done with that. I'm my own CEO. I can preach Jesus all day long, every single day, and I'll never lose my job. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, gosh, I love the Lord. Okay, here we go. Whether it be the fruits of the Spirit listed later on in this epistle or the display of miracle power, the works of the power can only happen through the obedience to faith and never by the works of law, which are lifeless religious forms. Paul proves throughout the epistle that the law is as opposite to the Spirit as its works are to faith. Did you get that one? Paul proves throughout this entire epistle that the law is opposite to the Spirit as its works are to faith. Paul likens the effectiveness of the works of the law to Abraham's relationship with Hagar, a relationship that could not bring to pass the will of God because it depended upon man's ability. Whereas the works that are shown to be that which only God can do through the miracle operation of the Spirit, the promise of God for Abraham and Sarah could only come by the miracle working power of the Spirit. Abraham and Sarah did not give birth to Isaac until after their own human ability had come to an end. Their own human ability came to an end. How many of you guys are struggling to do things on your own? Pay your bills, provide for your kids, provide the offering, provide whatever. How many of you guys literally, if you took a deep look into yourself, are doing it on your own strength? How many of us actually live like Pastor Mark, where he literally does not care ever if they have finances about anything at any time? Anytime. Literally, I'm proof of that. I share the same last name, so I know him pretty well. Honestly, it is the most miraculous living I've ever seen in my life, and it tries me and it tests me every single day. Every single day. Man must cease from trusting in himself and his own works. If we want the blessings of God, then we must turn in obedience to God and make him the sole object of our trust. If in doing so we will obey God and do what faith dictates, we will see the display of power of God at work in our lives. Amen. Woo! Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. All right, in closing, let's open up to 1 John 2:4. Amen. Hallelujah. Woo! I love this place. Love this place. Anna wakes up every day and asks me if we're going to church. Praise Jesus. I said, I wish we were going every single day. It's a great place to be filled up to overflow. First John 2:4. The one who says, I know him, but does not keep his commandments, is a liar, and the truth is not in him. Jesus spoke a number of different times about the commandment that he received of the Father to lay down his life. Jesus also gave commandments to his disciples. These commandments were directed at their love for one another. In fact, when we understand that God's commandments are focused on loving one another and that that love is divine love, we also realize that such a love is only possible by yielding to the operation of the Holy Spirit. Guys, we do not have divine love in us unless we're flowing in the Holy Ghost. I loved when Geneva broke off her relationship with AT&T. How many of us have been there when we're talking to someone that we cannot understand in some foreign country, you have kids screaming in the background, you've been on hold for 45 minutes and you just need to get the bill paid or just disconnect the service, and you literally are just like, Father, you better flow through me right now. You better flow that love like never before. I'm gonna love, 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 love. I mean, I have to minister to my spirit, because there's times where that's not what wants to come out. I want to rip their head off and tell them about what I was waiting for and how I did it. And guess what? My kids will do exactly the same, because you know the parents that do that. You watch their kids' response. They do the exact same thing. It's kind of scary. So one of the most amazing things, I'm going to finish this up real quick here. The key to walking in all the ways of God is to be ruled by divine love. The only way to be governed by divine love is to allow the Holy Spirit to rule our life and be our inspiration at every turn in our behavior. The love of God is the fulfillment of the whole law, because it works no wrongs against anyone. To walk in love is to walk in light, which the glory of God being revealed in his people. Amen. Amen. Brittany's testimony, there's a million more in this room, but I think that just hit me so hard, because when I met Summer, it was the first thing that she said to me. She said, I saw the love that she had, that she loved on the coworker. She's a manager at a burger place, guys. That's tough stuff. I don't know if you've ever probably done that, but managing a restaurant, that's pretty brutal. And it's a lot of hard work. But to come and show up every day to be filled with that divine love saved a soul who's now marrying my brother. Praise Jesus. I get to be sisters with Summer, soon to be Spitsbergen. Pretty excited about that. But do we have that love that overflows? Do we walk in the love that's the light, which is the glory of God being revealed in his people? Would people say that about you? Would they say that about you, Cade? Would they say that about you, Ruth, Brookie? Would they say, that person is so full of love, I know that person loves out of their whole being? Or would they say, that person's the most judgmental, hypocritical person I've ever met in my entire life? We got to take a look at ourselves, you guys. It starts with us. One of the most radical things is workplace evangelism. I love it. I love working and serving in a church, but I love being out there on the battlefield. And Ruth Ann and I had an amazing opportunity with a bunch of people last week just to share the love of Christ on them. And when we walked out of that place, I looked at Ruth. I'm like, I'm so blessed that God hooked us up together. I go, she's the most radical evangelist in this church. I don't care what you have to say. She's brought more people to this church to get healed, set free, and get their lives changed than anyone in this place. And it's true. And I admire that, and I'm passionate about that. Since we moved back, I said, Lord, every time I come, someone's coming with me. Well, guess what? I've only had 4 people. I've been here a month this week. I gotta increase. I gotta go to more people. I have to get out of my home. I gotta get to the grocery stores. I gotta get to the wherever it is, because my workplace is now a little bit in the home. But nonetheless, we were there, and I said to Ruth Anna, you are so awesome at being an evangelist. You are so awesome at bringing people to this church and getting them set free. And she said, it's all about showing them the love of Christ. It's all about loving on them, not coming to them and saying, you shouldn't be drinking, you are a sinner. They might never even know that that's the gospel of Christ, right? They might be Christian, but guess what? My Christian church in Chicago listens to Dave Matthews Band for worship. I don't even know if you know who that is, but it's not the Holy Ghost and fire. I'll tell you that. And when they talk about their sermons, it's not the gospel. There's not full gospel. There's not sitting in the place and your seat's on fire because literally Pastor Mark's reading your journal in front of the whole congregation. Anyone been there? Yeah. And then you maybe get a phone call afterwards, or your kid's freaking out in the front row. It's kind of funny that people message me that they feel bad for me after church. Guys, I love being corrected. I love it. Bring it. Bring it, Pastor Mark. Correct me every single day. I only want to grow in the things of God. I don't want my kids to be rebellious brats. I want them to be like Ruth Anna, Joshua, Daniel, and Elizabeth. Amen? I can't tell you how many times when people say to me, how did you get hooked up with the Spitsbergens? I'm like, Jesus. Jesus knew. I waited till I was 29 years old. It was looking a little bleak at the moment, I'm not going to lie. I was thinking, Lord, all right, no worries. I'm almost 30, but it's all good. I know you got someone. And the Lord answered every single prayer I had to be a part of the Spitsbergen family. That's not something I take lightly. It's not. It comes with a lot of hardship. I'll tell you that. They live in a glass house. You guys have pointed a lot of fingers and said a lot of mean things to them. And you know what? It doesn't matter, because we cut all that stuff off and we're walking in divine love. But I just want to share with you guys tonight that there's a call to action. I didn't just print out these notes and pray and hope that we would come here and have a lolly-dolly night. I didn't. I came here tonight to see you guys change from glory to glory. I came here tonight to see you activated in the things that God's called us to do. And I have some action points, and I want you guys to take them seriously. And I don't want you to run up here and respond and say, yeah, Allie, I'm going to do that, and quit on me in 6 weeks, because that's not being hooked up in the things of God. And a lot of you have quit on Pastor Geneva, a lot of you here, and you need to repent from that, because she's not the one that's running this entire church, and that's from the Holy Ghost. I know when the Holy Ghost comes on me and has a rebuke, and that is from the Holy Ghost. And when we decide that we're going to be responsive to the Word of God and we're going to respond to our pastors, you do not quit on that because it doesn't fit you anymore or you don't like toilets. You understand? Who cares if it's a toilet? Guess what? That's where God honors you and raises you up. You're faithful in a little bit, He will raise you up. Do you know that? Amen. If you do that job well, and that's the shiniest little toilet that anyone's ever going to sit on in their life, you will be raised up to do big things in God. I promise you that. So we have a call to action. Are you ready? Thank you, Jesus. How many of you are going to be committed to workplace and school evangelism? And that's not just like showing up and saying, Jesus loves you, Ruth. God bless you. Been good? Hey, oh my gosh, how's biology? Okay, Jesus loves you. Those are great. But the love message that Pastor wants us to have on our lips is what? What is the love message that we're supposed to have on our lips? Say it again really loud. And follow it up with, are you ready? Are you ready? Will you repent? Are you ready? Will you repent? Guys, I know that's hard. I know that's hard to get in people's grill, especially some of you that rather be in the back office and hoping that no one ever comes in. It's a real hard place to be on the forefront, I'll tell you that. It is very hard. I don't think anyone really loves to be on the spotlight and get in people's grill. I really don't. But That's what we're called to do, you guys. We are living in such perilous times, such perilous times. Again, we do not know if we have tomorrow. We don't even know, and I'm sorry to talk to you like that, but this is the truth. And when you touch death like I did, and maybe some of you guys have experienced that, you realize every breath you have is a gift from God and that you are called to do something with that. And it's not to go ridicule on a friend or speak guile on others. No, it's called to bless people and to set them free and to say, your house is on fire. I want to get you out in Jesus' name. Amen? Amen. Amen. So if you are committed to this kind of workplace and school evangelism, raise your hand. Raise your hand that you're going to walk out of this place. You're going to walk out of this place and the people you see tomorrow, you will have the words. Do you know that the wrath of God burns upon all sin? Are you ready? You don't have to give an answer. Pastor told us that on Sunday. We do not give an answer. The Word of God can stand on its own 2 feet. Amen? But we do have to be raised up, impacted. We have to be full of faith and in action to do this, guys, because God's depending on us. He's depending on this church, the abiding place, who's full of the Holy Spirit and power, who's full of signs, wonders, and miracles to be activated now. Guys, we can't sit in this place any longer to hang out. I'm sorry, it's not going to happen. It can't. It really can't. Not for you, not for this nation, especially for you, like I started off with. Joshua has built up in that faith to speak faith into the death of that medical situation. He was built up with it. It didn't come out on that night on March 29th. He had it in his life. Pastor Mark and Pastor Ann had that flowing in their life to see that happen. And we have to have that, guys. We have to have that Holy Spirit and fire. Amen. Amen. Number two, we're really passionate about stopping the murderhood of 61 million babies. I know you've seen... Maybe you don't follow me on Facebook. That's okay. But I have posted all 8 of the videos that have come out, and there's still more to come. I think they did almost 15 videos, and they get worse as they come out. Guys, this is something that we cannot stand by and do. And I called myself out. I shared that story with you guys about going to Planned Parenthood and the Lord sparing that precious baby's life. But where have I been? Because that wasn't yesterday. That was 7 years ago. 7 years ago, the same Planned Parenthood downtown San Diego has been aborting babies every single day, and I have not been there. So I'm calling myself out, and I am so thankful. Who all showed up on Saturday? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I had no idea what Saturday was going to be. I did not care. I asked Pastor if I could share it with you guys. I said, you know what? The prayers of the righteous availeth much. I am righteous. I am going there. I will pray and I will see breakthrough. And whatever the Lord's going to do, I will be there. I will show up. If there's one thing I learned about being in the abiding place, you must show up. Like Pastor said, you can't sit in your old house and say, oh my gosh, all the babies are being murdered. This is horrible. Show up. Get out on the street and do something about it. Don't sit in your little house and you sit there and just feel sorry for them. No, get activated. So you know what? We showed up. And you know what they were doing? Praying the rosary, saying Hail Marys, full of grace, the Lord be with you. I was like, oh, wow. Okay, dear Jesus, here we go. I came from the Catholic background. These are my people. I can do this. But we prayed in the Holy Spirit for 3 hours straight, activated that in our lives, and guess what? There was 2 demon-possessed people who got on every news station that taunted every single person in the crowd while the Christians stood back and just were, Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Oh my gosh, that lady's crazy. Someone pray for her, pray for her, pray for her. You guys pray for that lady, pray for that lady. I'm like, get them delivered. So guess who went after it? This guy. This guy ran them down the street and laid hands on them because it was a foul mocking spirit putting foul mocking signs in the air about Jesus coming back on foul things. And you know what? We were there because of those types of opportunities. We were there to be activated in our faith and in the power of what the Holy Spirit's going to do. And praise Jesus. Where's Jenny? Oh, Jenny Jen, I hate when Pastor calls you and you're not here, you know? Jenny had an opportunity, so I said, this girl's getting on the news all the time, right? This girl saying, I stand with Planned Parenthood, Republicans, all they care about is a fetus. Who even knows what the sign was? Doesn't even matter. All she wanted to do is taunt everyone. It was just an evil spirit trying to get in everyone's face, but that's what ran muck the entire 3 hours, and those that were there can run witness to that. But who cares about that? We're there to see her set free, see her give her life to the Lord. And so nonetheless, Casey or Jenny runs up to the film guy and is like, you need to hear Allie's story. And so I walked up to Fox News and I said, I'd love to share my story. And so I did. I shared why I was there. I shared that I did not come there to shame everyone that was going in there that already has a hardness of heart. I sat in that lobby for 3 hours and I saw when those people came in. The last thing they wanted to do is to see a Christian there and be like, you sinner, you're going to hell. They wanted to say, I love you. I will adopt that baby. I am here for you. We can do this together. And that's what saved that little boy 7 years ago. That love that I had for her, that the Holy Spirit gave me. And so we got on the news. I shared that story. Gustavo, praise God, he has a TV with cable, saw it, because we don't, and we didn't get to see it. But that was, some of you guys were asking me, Allie, what are we doing? Like, I feel like we're not doing anything. And I love the wisdom of my husband, and I'm so honored to be in marriage with him. He said, babe, we're here and waiting on the Holy Spirit. We're waiting on the Holy Ghost to act when he tells us to do so. We're not here in vain. We're here hooked up with the Holy Spirit to act. And how awesome for the Lord to do those things, to be raising us up. And when we got to church that Sunday and Pastor said, how many times this week have you been pressed up against about your faith? Have you been challenged in your faith? Have you had to like have the word on your tongue to refute people, to pray for people? And if I didn't go to Planned Parenthood, I think that would have been maybe once or twice. At that Planned Parenthood, we had about 30 experiences and 30 minutes to go talk to people about that and be ready to give account on everything. Amen? So my next call to action to you guys is this is making you sick, and it should. This is a murder of babies. And just like Pastor said, in Moloch time, they threw their babies in the fire, and people thought that was horrible. We are selling baby parts for profit. Your tax dollars are funding murder of babies. My child was born the size of the babies that are being sold, crushed, cut open with a live beating heart. You don't think that's going to make me sit in my little room and feel sorry for myself? No, I'm going to get on the streets and cause to action, and we're going to do greater things. And I want this church and you guys that are passionate like me, with veins coming out of my head, I never know what I look like when I preach, praise God. We're not going to watch the video. But if you guys want to be hooked up with that, I want you to be activated to do it. Heaven knows that Pastor Geneva and I can make all these plans and delegate everything out, but that's okay. But we don't want to be those people. I want KC, who just emailed me before. She's fired up about this. KC, I want you to be hooked up with that. I want you and other people to make a schedule of the times that we're down at Planned Parenthood at that surgical center and that we're praying for these babies daily. And there's a 40-day of prayer and fasting coming up for the 40 days of life from September 23rd to November 1st. And I pray that us as a church, that we get called to action, that we put this faith that James talks about in 122, and we really are doers of the word of God, and that we do pray and fast for 40 days. I promise it won't kill any of you, even if it's just one meal or one thing. And so I pray that if people want to be called to action, I ask who's going to stand up? Who's going to stand up for the voiceless? Who's going to go down to Planned Parenthood and pray? Who's going to be a part of the 40 days of praying? And guess what? It might not be for the babies. It's going to be for someone on that street that you need to talk to, that God's going to use you divinely to set them free on their path to eternity of hell, eternity, forever, forever, forever. How many of you guys are called to that action? How many of you guys are hooked up in that? Praise Jesus. Praise God. That's amazing. Is Trisha here? Church, kids' church? She walked up the stairs. We'll wait on her. Street evangelism. Jason. Where's Jason? In the back. Jason, I knew you had a radical street evangelism. You and Robert were going out in the streets, down in PB, where God knows what was going on, and seeing radical things happen. And it was so encouraging to me to go out with you guys and just see what was going on and see the boldness that they had to see people set free. And I know there's a lot of evangelism opportunities, and I know now that Paulina has left and Pastor Kelly's traveling and stuff like that, but who's called to the streets? We're called to the streets. The entire church is called to the streets to be doing street evangelism. I think the stories that Pastor Mark shares are so radical about him getting up on flagpoles wherever he could just to be shouting the message of the gospel. Like we said, there's power in declaring the word of God. It stands on its own two feet. It doesn't return void. You don't do it in vain. But we need to be activated tonight, church. We need to make a commitment. We need to rise up to make a commitment. I don't care if it's Thursday for 3 minutes. I'm starting small. I'm starting small potatoes because I just want people to get hooked up with this and I want them to burn inside them like it burns in me and it burns in my family. 3 minutes on a Thursday to maybe go to the Mira Mesa Vons and tell someone that the wrath of God burns upon all sin. Are you ready? Can I pray for you? Can I take you to church with me? I love carpool evangelism. It's the best thing ever. They're in your car and you're talking, right? They can't get out. You're on the highway. You got them captivated. Same thing with airplane evangelism. And we fly a lot. They get sitting next to me. They're like, can I move my seat? But that's okay, because guess what? We've seen great fruit out of the relationships that we've built on airplanes. And we're going to see greater things because we're going to see these people make heaven and say, yeah, Southwest Flight 40. You, me. I believe it. I believe that, you guys. God's giving us divine appointments every single day. You got to open your eyes. You got to listen up because God's going to be using you. Trisha, I love you. So Trisha got in touch with the Turning Point, which is the Pregnancy Crisis Center right here in our local community in Mira Mesa. They're a faith-based clinic that some of you guys have already worked with, and they have tons of needs right now. And so that's another thing, a part of being a part of this planned murderhood and praying this thing down, being a part of a place that's allowing the high-risk pregnancies and doing something about it and really being used in mighty ways. And Trisha's going to be giving us information about how we can best be used there, and we're going to get that guys out to you. Okay, last is social media. You guys, that's the way everything's going, social media. But guess what? Satan is running amok with social media. If you can't be on it because you struggle there, do not listen to this part. Count yourself out. Delete the app on your phone. Delete your account. Let someone know that you're never allowed to be on it again because it is a devil's hell on there. For sure. But for those of you that have stood strong and that you're okay with it, we need to start using it to preach the gospel. We have to use it to share these videos about planned murderhood. We have to use it to tell people about the miracles and signs and wonders that are happening here in the Abiding Place 3 times a week and get them here. And so I want someone to rise up with social media. I want someone to make an event every single meeting that we all like and we all say that we're going, because guess what? That pops up in everyone's little news feed and they're like, maybe that's the day that they decided to commit suicide. Maybe that's the day that things got so bad, but they saw that Ruth Anna, who invited them to church 3,002 times, is going to the Abiding Place and there's going to be signs, wonders, and miracles. And she reaches out to her and says, tonight's my night. I got the address, because all you have to do is click when it's an event page, and they show up here and they get set free. Does anyone else feel that in their bones besides me? That is so simple. It is so simple. If you use social media, my mom uses it. My mom cannot use the computer. She uses social media. So if you want to be hooked up in that and make an events page, or if you feel still weak and feeble, share everything that comes out of Pastor Ruth's mouth. Share everything that comes out of Pastor Mark's mouth. All you do is hit share on there, and it pops up in your news feed for people to see. Brittany, I was so honored when you wrote me and you said, thank you for taking a stand for Planned Parenthood and really posting all these things out. Because guess what, guys? A lot of people hate me right now. A lot. It all started with the same-sex marriage thing. A lot of hate, literally on my own page and blasting it in front of everyone. And it shook me. I'll have to be honest. It shook me. And praise God, I have people like Pastor Ruth in my life. She's like, are you serious? You're bothered by that? And I was like, no. no. She goes, you think they hate you? They hate God. They're yelling at God. That whole post about you is about God. They don't hate you. And guess what? Am I going to let 2 little demon spirits close me down? And what I'm going to say, because so many people have been set free, I can't even share the testimonies of people that have reached out to me that have had abortions, that are struggling, that are wanting to be set free from it, that people are that are in same-sex marriages that are struggling. They know they're wrong, and they want to get set free of it. That's what I'm looking at. I'm looking at the fruit and the evangelistic part that I can use on Facebook and social media. So if you want to be raised up in that, raise your hand. Say, I will use my social media pages for the things of God, and I will be loud about it, and I won't back down and be scared that someone's going to blast me on my own social media page. Because guess what? There's a delete button, and you can block them. So who cares what they have to say? You have something to say, okay? We have something to say. So thank you, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. I love this church. I love that there was a call to action and that everyone was a part of it. And I don't even know what time it is, but that's okay. Are we good? Okay, praise God. So what I want us to do is I want us all to come up here, church. I want everyone to make a proclamation. If you raised your hand about being activated in something, or honestly, if you need to repent to Geneva because you quit on the job she gave you in 6 days, 6 weeks, or 6 months, you should probably do that too, because that's where your breakthrough is going to be tonight. But I want us all to press in. I want us all to have this power demonstrated in our life, this faith and action that they talk about. I want us to be Pauls in this nation, in this neighborhood. I want us to be activated. And guys, if you're coming up here and you're like, I can't believe the meeting's still going because I'm tired, rebuke that. Rebuke the tiredness of spirit. Because guess what? That is not of God. God fills us up. He fills us up to overflow. I promise you, I have not slept a lot lately. God is working in me, a lot of different things that are going on. But I can tell you, when I get in this place, I get hooked up to an IV from Pete's Coffee, and I'm like, woo! Here we go, here we go, here we go. And that's not Pete's Coffee. That's the Holy Spirit. But I've learned to activate that because I used to come to these meetings tired. I used to yawn during worship. And then I thought about how that affected Father, that I would come into his courts, which says come with what? Thanksgiving and praise. And I yawned. Are you kidding me? Tell you, I'm not doing that anymore. I'm never going to do that again because I got hooked up in something. There's an open heaven when you get in here. And if you haven't touched it, come early. Come for prayer. If you have kids and they're distracting, tell someone to take the kids that you can press in. Even better, you know what Pastor said to me the other day? You worry about yourself getting hooked up. You don't worry that Naomi's eating rocks or fell off the stage. You worry about yourself, no joke. You worry about yourself getting hooked up, and your kids will flow in the Holy Spirit. Sunday night, Anna sat there for 4 hours. 4 hours. I mean, are you kidding me? She's the biggest spitfire we've seen after all the Spitsbergens that are already here. But that is amazing. But that's pressing in ourselves. Parents, when we press into that, our kids receive that. And I want that. I don't want a bratty kid that's like, I need kids church and gummy worms or whatever. I don't know what they serve. But anyway, I want my kids to be hooked up with that. Because guess what? She's in a school right now, and they asked her, do you listen to Frozen? She goes, no, only worship CDs. They're like, is she serious? I'm like, yeah, my husband's a worship pastor. And she's like, yeah, and we flow in the Holy Ghost. She's 4 and a half. She flows in the Holy Ghost. All right? Well, guess what? We're going to see revival happen at that Cambridge school. I'm telling you that. We already did. I got to pray for someone in the parking lot today. It's day one. It wasn't even day one. It was before they even started. Before we started praying for people in the parking lot. Come on, guys. That's workplace evangelism. That's school evangelism. That's picking up the phone. There's people that never get out of their house. But you know what? There's a telephone. You pick it up and you say, Lord, who's hurting today? Who do you have a word for? And you might mess up. I've messed up. I'm like, whoa, sorry, just kidding. I love you. Awesome. But guess what? Now my words are pretty right on. When the Lord speaks through me, but that was all activated through Father, I don't want to mess up. Father, I want to be so sensitive to you and sensitive to the things of you. When I come up here, I don't come up here because I want you guys to hear my voice, that's for sure. No, not at all. I mean, I come up here and it's like crushing my chest. I used to walk out of this place with words for you guys, and I would go home and not deliver them. And one night, I literally couldn't breathe. And I called Pastor at 12:30 and I said, I'm not doing this anymore. And he said, what? And I said, I get so nervous about saying anything because I think it might be wrong or that someone's going to be embarrassed. And right now I can't breathe. And I have such a conviction of the Holy Ghost. I don't care if I get up there and it's totally outlandish and it's to Mars, but I will always respond and I will always be right. And guys, that changed me. That changed the things that come to me. Like even the other day on Sunday, he's like, you better be flowing with me. You better be flowing with me. I'm like, oh, Lord, no. And so I said Psalms 2, that there are 27 was on my heart. And then he texts me afterwards, like, great flow, great word, guys. And I was like, thank you, Jesus, for that such a sensitivity, you guys. And we all have that. We all have words. We're all meant to prophesy. We're all meant to see this stuff. It's not just supposed to be Ruth, who's amazing. I'm so blessed. I've been listening to her clip just so I could learn how to interpret the gift of tongues all over and over and over, but it just refreshes my soul. And one quick thing about social media, I've been taking 1 minute clips of worship because the Lord told me this is your avenue, this is your platform, that's what my business is. It's a virtual franchise that leverages social media. And I put these clips up and you guys, they've had thousands and thousands of views. 1 minute clips of being here. That music isn't just music. That's an anointing that goes forth. We've had so many testimonies. I don't know if you've seen it, but people started writing testimonies about what's happened when this worship team is playing their music. That is amazing, you guys. They might not come here, but you can post. I love watching Leslie post. She puts the words. She puts exactly what pastor's doing here at church. You know, that's radical. If they're not coming here, we're going out to them. We're going straight to their news feeds. Amen? Amen. So let's lift our hands to the Lord. Let's cry out to him that we would be activated as a church tonight. Tonight. Time to rise up, church. It's time to rise up now. It's time to rise up. Break that tiredness off your body right now. You got to start rising up. Tonight's your night. Your night for change. Don't leave this place the same way you came in. Do not miss your opportunity tonight to receive from the Lord all you need. In Jesus' name. The fire of the Holy Spirit. The fire of the Holy Spirit comes on you. Burns you up. Burns up everything not pleasing to the Lord. Now, in Jesus' name, you rise up, Nadine. You rise up for such a time as this. This is your generation. In Jesus' mighty name. In Jesus' mighty name. Never the same. Thank you.
King of glory, you're the King of the ages, you're the King of glory, you're the King of the ages. King of glory, you're the King of the ages, you're the King of glory, you're the King of the ages. You're the King of glory, you're the King of the ages. You're the King of glory, the King of the ages. King of glory, you're the King of the ages, you're the King of glory, you're the King of the ages, you're the King of glory, you're the King of the ages, you're the King of glory. The King of the ages. The King of glory, the King of the ages, the King of glory. The King of the ages, so the King of glory, the King of the ages. But you set my feet a dancing, you fill my mouth with praise. You set my feet a dancing, you fill my mouth with praise. But you set my feet a dancing, you fill my mouth with praise. But you set my feet a dancing, you fill my mouth with praise. O King of glory, King of the ages, the King of glory, you're the King of the ages, you're the King of glory, you're the King of the ages. King of glory, you're the King of the ages, you're the King of glory, you're the King of the ages, you're the King of glory, you're the King of the ages, you're the King of glory. The King of the ages, you're the King of glory, you're the King of the ages. set my feet a-dancing. You fill my mouth with praise. Lord, you set my feet a-dancing. You fill my mouth with praise. Lord, you set my feet a-dancing. You fill my mouth with praise. Lord, you set my feet a-dancing. You fill my mouth with praise. King of glory, King of the ages, you're the King of glory. The King of the ages, you're the King of glory. The King of the ages. Set my feet a-dancing. You fill my mouth with praise. Lord, you set my feet a-dancing. You fill my mouth with praise. Lord, you set my feet a-dancing. You fill my mouth with praise. Oh, you set my feet a-dancing. You fill my mouth with praise, King of glory, King of the ages, you're the King of glory, you're the King of the ages, you're the King of glory, you're the King of the ages, you're the King of glory. The King of the ages. King of glory, the King of the ages, you're the King of glory, you're the King of the ages, you're the King of glory, you're the King of the ages. Lord, you set my feet a-dancing. You fill my mouth with praise. Lord, you set my feet a-dancing. You fill my mouth with praise. Lord, you set my feet a-dancing. You fill my mouth with praise. Lord, you set my feet a-dancing. You fill my mouth with praise, King of glory. King of the ages, you're the King of glory. The King of the ages. King of the ages, the King of glory, the King of the ages, you're the King of glory, You're the King of the ages. You're the King of glory. You're the King of the ages. You're the King of glory. The King of the ages. Lord, you set my feet a dancing. You fill my mouth with praise. But you set my feet a dancing. And you fill my mouth with praise. But you set my feet a dancing. And you fill my mouth with praise. But you set my feet a dancing. And you fill my mouth with praise. King of glory. King of the ages, you're the King of glory. The King of the ages, you're the King of glory. The King of the ages, you're the King of glory. The King of the ages. My feet are dancing. You fill my mouth with praise. Lord, you set my feet are dancing. And you fill my mouth with praise. Lord, you set my feet are dancing. You fill my mouth with praise. As you set my feet are dancing. And you fill my mouth with praise. King of glory, you're the King of glory, you're the King of glory, you're the King of the ages, you're the King of glory, you're the King of the ages, you're the King of glory. The King of the ages, you're the King of glory. You're the King of the ages, Lord, you set my feet a dancing. You fill my mouth with praise, Lord, you set my feet a dancing. You fill my mouth with praise. Lord, you set my feet a dancing. You fill my mouth with praise. King of glory. King of the ages. King of glory. The King of the ages. You're the King of glory. King of the ages, you're the King of glory. You're the King of the ages. King of glory, the King of the ages, You're the King of glory, the King of the ages. You're the King of glory, you're the King of the ages. You're the King of glory, you're the King of the ages. Lord, you set my feet to dance. You fill my mouth with praise. Lord, you set my feet a dancing. You fill my mouth with praise. Lord, you set my feet a dancing. You fill my mouth with praise. King of glory, King of the ages, King of glory, King of the ages. You're the King of glory, you're the King of the ages. You're the King of glory, you're the King of the ages.
You're the
King of the ages, would you set my feet a dancing? You fill my mouth with praise, would you set my feet a dancing? You fill my mouth with praise, would you set my feet a dancing? You fill my mouth with praise, King of glory, you're the King of the ages, you're the King of glory, you're the King of the ages, you're the King of glory, you're the King of the ages, you're the King of glory. King of the ages. King of glory, the King of the ages, the King of glory, the King of the ages, the King of glory, the King of the ages, the King of glory. The King of the ages, you're the King of glory. The King of the ages. Thank you.
Church, all we have need of, He abundantly supplies to us. All we have need of. All. Not some, not a little bit. All. All your needs will be supplied. The riches of heaven. That's so radical. That's so radical. You should never, ever worry about rent or gas bills or anything another day, another minute of your life. The richness of heaven being deposited into bank accounts tonight. That is so radical. We have been so broke where we didn't even have two pennies to put together. $3 million projects, or activate to be funded to go to Nepal and help them rebuild all three of these orphanages, or send the money to do so. Be activated to do big things in God. Be used for mighty signs and wonders. Be used with the Holy Spirit and power. Guys, there's no other way to live, I promise you. There's no other way to live. It is so good. It'll cost you everything. Think of what you have now, and it's nothing compared to heaven. I'll tell you that. I don't care what your house looks like or what kind of car you drive. Ask the Lord to reveal heaven to you. Reveal it to you. What does heaven look like? And everything here will fade away in 2.2 seconds. I don't know if that's 2.2 seconds. 0.2 seconds. We love you guys so much. We are so honored to be a part of this church and this family. It is such an honor to be asked to minister the things that God's, you know, shared with us, and read the daily breads. Does everyone read the daily bread? Those are so rich. You might have noticed that some of this stuff has come from a past daily bread. They're so rich to supply our manna from heaven every single day. When Anna was born, she had no amniotic fluid. I don't know if you know what that means, but it basically means she was supernaturally supplied from manna from heaven. And I think about that all the time, that the Lord supplied her life, but He wants to supply our lives every single day the same way, like the nutrients that she didn't get. But this is so much richer, so much richer. I pray tonight that you leave this place totally different than the way you came in. And I pray that you're activated in that power. And if Paul saw you, he would say, Kate and Ruthanna, there is power and fruits in your ministry. Amen. It's happening, guys. He's no respecter of persons. I was raised a Catholic. I came to the Abiding Place 7 years ago. Most of you have been here 12 times longer. Awesome. Don't forsake the Lord with your tithes and your offerings. Don't bother anyone on the ground. There's a lot of needs at the MTC. Pastor doesn't talk about, but I can. Pastor works night and day. He doesn't even eat. He doesn't drink. He goes from morning till night working at these things that the Lord's put on his heart. And if you are hooked up with that and you want to be a part of it, it starts with a simple act of saying, Lord, use me to be a blessing. When you guys, the youth campers, were up at MTC, it was so radical. Those that really have a vision for the things of MTC. And ask the Lord to bless your finances, that your 10 cents turns into $10, turns into $10,000. We're living proof of what God can do when you activate that faith, you guys. I was in this first row right here when that faith came upon me to make wealth for the MTC. And it's, again, not a respecter of person. I'm not a very good businesswoman. But I had that faith activated in me, and I stay at it. I stay at it every single day. I work as though I'm working for the Lord, not for a company, not for a business, but I work as though I work for the Lord, and I give my all day in and day out. I give myself to excellence. Joshua's music was birthed out of excellence. The guy does it excellently. And so I pray that you guys see that in your own ministries. Give yourself to excellence. Give yourself to overflowing in the things of God. Give yourselves to that divine love. It is so awesome when you meet people that are like just divine love. You just want to like you never want to leave them, right? And that's such an open door to preach into people's lives and to share the things of God, because they see that love on you and they don't know what it is, but they're like, I think I need that. And it's amazing. It's powerful.